What's good YouTube? Akil here, back with another video, and today I'm going to be sharing just some of my favorite clothing sales from the month of November. Now, right now it's November 17th, so we're right in the middle of November, and I usually specialize in men's shoes and women's shoes as well, and I've also been selling a ton of electronics lately. But in today's particular video, I just want to really lock in on some of the clothing sales, mainly because I know a lot of people that watch this channel are also clothing sellers, so some of these items will kind of give you guys just a better idea of what buyers are looking for, especially during Q4. I tell you guys all the time, boots, coats, sweaters, stuff like that is what people are looking for right now. So I think this video will give you guys a really good idea of what brands to be on the lookout for, whether you guys shop at places like Burlington and Ross and Marshalls and stuff like that, or if you guys are sometimes in the thrift stores and these flea markets as well. So without further ado, let's get into it. All right, y'all. So first up, I have this bomber jacket from the brand Alpha Industries, and I've actually sold maybe 10 or 12 of these jackets over the past 3 to 4 months. Every time I saw these in Ross, they were selling them for just about $25, and every time I seen them, regardless of the size, I always grabbed them up. Sometimes if I seen like an extra small, I might actually pass on those, but I was seeing these really, really often in a bunch of different colors, and I even kept a burgundy one for myself. But in terms of the green and the white Alpha Industry jackets, I've been selling these like crazy, anywhere between $85 and $69.99. Right now, I think I have one jacket left, and the majority of them have been selling for that $69.99 price point. I found a couple that were 2XL, and I actually just charged $85 for those, and people were actually picking those up a few months ago. Right now, I think, especially with all the other competition, people are really just selling these for anywhere between $65 and as high as about maybe $75. Drop a comment if you guys are selling these jackets, if you sold them in the past. But for me, like I said, I've sold a ton of these, and I'm just glad that I was picking them up and making the investment earlier on while they were readily available. Because right now, if you was to walk into Ross, you might come across some extra smalls or maybe a small, but very, very rare to come across some of those more desirable sizes. So if you guys can even find some Alpha Industries jackets in the thrift, definitely pick those up as well, because those are super popular right now. Bomber jackets are very, very trendy, and this is just the perfect time to be trying to flip those and make some decent profit. Next up, we got a thrift store find, and this is actually a vintage Guess leather jacket. Now, when I picked this jacket up, I think it was I featured this maybe in like a trip to the thrift video or maybe like a Ross pickup video, and I just kind of shared that at the end. But I remember picking this jacket up for I think $25, either $20 or $25, and of course it was in the middle of the summer, so finding leather jackets like that was the perfect time to pick those up, mainly because it wouldn't be too expensive and other people wouldn't be willing to pick it up. So for me, as soon as I saw it, I knew it was going to be good money, and I just knew I would have to wait for the right buyer to come along, because these vintage Guess jackets, the comps are all over the place. You might find some and they'll sell for as low as $30, and then you might find a different one that sells as high as like $300 or $400. So for me, I knew this one was gonna be dope, and this one sold for $127.49. Very random price, but I've been running a sale for the whole month of November, and a lot of items I've been selling have been on sale, but then some items I'm not even putting on sale. So I'm just seeing a really steady amount of traffic, a really steady amount of consistent sales, and it's been doing wonders for the business, especially since we're in the home buying process right now. And for those of you that can relate, I'm on a buying freeze. I haven't been shopping as much as I usually do, only because I'm trying to keep my expenses low. So thankfully, a lot of the items that I'm going to be sharing in today's video, I've picked these items up months ago, sometimes several weeks ago. So this jacket in particular, picked this one up a while ago, had it listed for $150, and it was able to sell with that 15% off sale. So definitely keep that in mind in case you guys are experiencing some slow sales. You might just want to run a quick promotion or just like a small weekend sale just to drive some more traffic and drive some more sales. Next up, speaking of vintage items, we got this vintage Obermeyer ski suit. Now, I actually had this in my death pile for a very long time, probably 2 years that I just had it sitting. I just didn't want to list it. It was just one of those things that was really big and bulky, just in the way, and I didn't want to bother with it. But like I said, I've been on a buying freeze, so everything in my death pile, I've been just listing them slowly and periodically throughout the last few weeks. And as soon as I listed this for $110, it sold, I think, the next day or maybe 2 days later for $110. And when I picked this up, this had to be no more than $8 or $9 because I picked it up when I lived in California, and anything outerwear used to sell for no more than $10. So this was definitely a really good find, and it was one of those items that I was just glad that I actually held on to it because now I need that money definitely more than ever. So this was a really good flip, and like I said, the brand is Obermeyer. So if you come across some Obermeyer jackets, not all of them sell for like a lot of profit, but if you can find the ski suits and the full snow suits, definitely pick those up because those bring in some good profit. Next up is a Ross find, and I actually picked this up for only $20, and this is a pair of overalls from Levi's, and it's actually a Levi's Made and Crafted times Pogi collab. So this one did have a little bit of hype towards it because Pogi is definitely more of like a menswear, like menswear legend, and at the end of the day this one sold for $110, but this item in particular wasn't even listed on sale, so that was also kind of refreshing to see. And it sold for $110. Like I said, I picked this up for only $20 from Ross, and I don't know if it was a lot of these in Ross at one point or another, but I just found one in a size small, and it took maybe 3 or 4 weeks for this to sell, but it finally did sell for a ton of profit. Next up, you keeping it going with the Ross finds, I actually picked up this jacket from Ross for $29.99, and I had like 3 or 4 of these. I had some in a size small, some in a medium, some in large. I think I still have some extra large listed in my store right now, but all of the mediums have sold out, and like I said, picked them up for $29.99 and they sold for $90. So a really good amount of profit on these. Only thing is I definitely had to wait a little while until these started to move, because I picked these up a few months ago in Ross when Ross first started like kind of just starting to unload some of their outerwear. So right now I'm not sure if you guys might come across these in Ross, but like I said, I picked up maybe 7 or 8 of these jackets, and I've been selling all of them for a good amount of profit. So definitely keep that in mind if you guys are in Ross trying to find some good jackets to flip. Next up is a thrift store find, and this is actually a St. Louis Blues hockey jersey. Now when I went to the thrift, this had to be maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago. It was just four jerseys that they've just brought out on the rack, and like I said, they were all like between $7.99 and $9.99, all St. Louis Blues jerseys. So this person definitely had to be a collector, and one sold for $60, and I still have one listed in my store right now. That one is actually from Pro Player, and like I told you guys, it's just more like a vintage piece, so it might sit for a while, but I usually only sell CCM jerseys or Reebok hockey jerseys. Now that Pro Player one is kind of the first of its kind for me to come across, so hopefully that brings in some good profit. But like I said, this one sold for $60, and I picked this one up for I think $7.99. really good condition, did have some minor snags on there, but I make sure that I always keep a fabric shaver just to kind of get rid of some of the snags and some of the pulls and just the overall lint, and I was able to clean this up and make it look really nice, and it sold for some good money in a decent amount of time. Next up is another thrift store find, and this is actually a Devold Ohms Coretti sweater. Now I'm not even sure if I said that name the correct way, but I saw this sweater, and I know those like chunky Norwegian types of sweaters always sell for some good money, and when I picked this one up, I literally didn't even see the tag. I instantly just drew my attention to the actual design of the overall sweater, and once I got home and I checked the comps, I saw that they were selling anywhere between like $30 and as high as like $80. Now I ended up selling mine on sale for $50.99, but at the end of the day I probably could have listed this for a little higher and got some more money. Maybe as the winter progressed, I probably could have got maybe even $100 for this sweater, who knows. But this is definitely a good bolo for you guys to be on the lookout for. So if you guys come across this brand, definitely pick it up. I'm not gonna say it sells super fast, it sold maybe within 3 or 4 weeks, but for me that's a really quick turnaround time. Next up is this jacket that I actually pulled out of Dom's closet because she doesn't even wear this coat anymore, and she just was trying to just get rid of some stuff that she had laying around the house. So I listed this jacket for her, and this is a jacket I actually picked up for her when we actually first started dating. I remember I picked it up from this website called Gilt. I don't think they're actually still around anymore, but I think I spent maybe $100, maybe $120 on this coat, and she wore it a ton when we were living in Buffalo when we first met. And just after a while, she just stopped wearing this coat, especially since we're in Arizona now and we're barely ever wearing any heavy coats and jackets and stuff like that. So I listed this for her, and it ended up selling for $42.49. The brand is Via Spiga. Definitely a well-known women's brand. I think it sells more in like Nordstrom Rack and places like that. So if you guys come across that brand, you want to check the comps first, because it's not like a very expensive brand by any means. Like I said, I picked it up brand new for only like $120, and was still able to bring in some decent money with this after selling it like 5 or 6 years later. So definitely be on the lookout for this brand, and just always check the comps and do the research before you list stuff like this. Next up is another thrift store find, and this is actually a pair of cargo pants from the brand Cool K-U-H-L. And if you guys are a long time follower of this channel, you guys know that I've been just singing high praises about this brand for a very long time. Anytime I come across some of the cargos or the jackets or the sweaters, they always sell really, really quick for a decent amount of profit. And I picked this up from the thrift store just last week for, it was only, I think, $4. That's the only reason why I was able to pick it up, because it was something that I wouldn't feel guilty about making a purchase with. And it sold within a couple of days for $40. So really quick turnaround, made my profit back really, really fast. So anytime I come across this brand, I usually always pick it up. Next up is a Ross Find, and this is actually a Adidas ZNE Fast Relief hoodie. Now, this hoodie was really dope in my opinion. Picked this up during the summertime when hoodies and stuff like that were, you can find like really dope stuff in Ross during that time before, you know, the season started to change. So I was sitting on this for maybe 2 or 3 months, and I only spent $20 on this sweater, and it sold for $69.99. So really good deal on this one. And even though it did take some time for it to flip, I'm still glad I was able to pick this up because it brought in some decent profit. And like I said, stuff like this is the type of pieces that I know I would wear. So that's usually how I kind of base my judgment in terms of picking up stuff from Ross. I try to stick to more Nike, more Adidas. I don't usually pick up too much Under Armour pieces because I'm not a fan. But if you guys are a fan of Under Armour, definitely grab some of those The Rock, anything with like that Brahma Bull logo on there. Definitely pick that up because that's more of the stuff that people like from Under Armour. And last but certainly not least, we got another Ross find. And this is actually a set that I put together. I actually found the jacket from one Ross, and then like 2 or 3 weeks later, I found the pants in the same size. So I just listed it as a complete tracksuit. And this is actually sold part of the sale, that 15% off sale. I had this listed for $115, and it eventually sold for $97.74 since it was 15% off. So I think I spent $20 on the pants and then $30 on the jacket. So not a ton of profit was made here. This was actually one of my, probably an item that I probably should have passed on, but I just know people are definitely wearing more of these baggier, like loose fitting track suits and stuff like that. So that's what made me want to pick it up since this style is trending. But for me, I'm just glad that I was able to pick this up and flip it in a decent amount of time. All right, y'all, that's all I have for today's video. So if you guys enjoyed that one, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.